In last two videos, we have learned about bifurcation. Bifurcation in biological systems can give rise to very interesting phenomena. In this video, we will take the example of bifurcation in cell cycle. We will learn about bistability and hysteresis. Here is the diagram of cell cycle. You must have seen this in textbooks. Between two mitotic division, a cell goes through three phases, G1, S and G2. This cycle is unidirectional. The cell gets committed in one phase to move to the next one. In G1, the cell duplicates its cellular machinery, copies organelles and increases size. DNA replication happens in the S phase. S phase is followed by the G2 phase where the cell gets ready for mitosis. For simplification, we will consider S, G2 and M phases as one single phase. In G1 phase, the cell decides to move forward into the S phase. There are large number of molecules that control the cell cycle. In our simplified model, we consider only a single cyclin CDK complex and APC. Cyclin CDK complex phosphorylates many proteins and triggers the transition from G1 to SG2M phase. APC is an ubiquitin ligase. It can be in active and inactive form. APC gets activated through different molecular cues. Active APC promotes degradation of the cyclin CDK complex and also helps in the completion of mitosis. On the other hand, cyclin CDK complex promotes inactivation of APC. So here is our simplified, rather oversimplified model for cell cycle. C is the cyclin CDK complex and A is the active APC. P is the control parameter for bifurcation analysis. It can be imagined as a molecular cue that triggers activation of APC. I have drawn the bifurcation diagram for C. I have not shown the diagram for A, but C and A are mutually opposing. So A has just the opposite behavior in the bifurcation diagram. When C is high, A will be low and vice versa. This bifurcation diagram has two saddle node bifurcation points, S1 and S2. The stable steady states are in blue and the unstable one is in yellow. For P less than P1, the system has only one steady state with very high C. This steady state is stable. In this state, A will be very low. Similarly, for P greater than P2, the system has one stable steady state. Here C is very low, but A is very high. However, between P1 and P2, the system has two stable steady states separated by one unstable steady state. This region is called the bistable region. In G1 phase, P remains high. Say P equal to 0.4. In this condition, the system is monostable and C remains very low. As the cell grows in the G1 phase, P drops. But as long as P is bigger than P2, the cell stays at a stable steady state with low C. But below P2, the system is in the bistable zone. There are two stable steady states. One with low C and the another with high C. Will the cell move to the higher stable steady state or to the lower stable steady state? To answer this question, we will check the phase plane plot. Suppose P is equal to 0.3. So the system is monostable. Wherever it starts, with time, eventually the cell reaches the steady state at A and stays there. Now imagine that P dropped from 0.3 to 0.2. That changes the phase portrait. Now the system has two stable steady states, P and R. The new stable steady state at P is very close to the earlier steady state at A. Note that all trajectories in the vicinity of P are collapsing to P. So the cell at A will now move to P, the lower stable steady state. There is no trajectory in the phase plane for the cell to go to R from A. So in the bistable zone, the cell stays at the lower stable steady state for any value of P. But once P drops below P1, a drastic event happens. The system has now only one stable steady state with high C. So the cell jumps to that steady state. C increases drastically. The cell leaves G1 phase and enters the SG2M. As the cell moves through SG2M phase, P starts increasing. However, even in the bistable zone, C remains on the higher stable steady state. Once P is bigger than P2, the cell is again in a monostable zone and jumps to the steady state with low C. This leads the cell to the G1 phase. One cell cycle is now complete. So here I have shown the complete journey of the cell through different steady states. The white arrow shows the path followed by the cell when P decreases from high value. The green one is for the return journey. Here the paths of the onward and backward journeys are different. This behavior is called hysteresis. In a way, hysteresis is memory. Here the cell has the molecular memory of the phase of the cell cycle. Such memory is crucial in a fluctuating environment. Imagine that we have treated a cell with a growth factor that caused a rapid decrease in P and the cell moved to SG2M phase. Now, even if we remove the growth factor or even if the growth factor gets decayed, the cell will complete the SG2M phase till P remains lower than P2. So once the cell has committed for the cell cycle, it will complete its job. That's all for this video. In the next video, we will learn about another interesting effect of bifurcation in cell biology.